Thank you. Okay. What's up, you guys? Hello again. Welcome to another gaming episode here. My bad. I'm having a lot of audio issues tonight. So basically, I have been live streaming, or I am live streaming, and doing like gaming shows and stuff. And so it's all a learning experience for me. Like today, I've taken a lot of time to like figure out how to get myself in a square so I can get with you guys and you guys can hear me and see me while I'm playing these games. You guys could not hear me because I'm having sound issues. I think you guys can hear me now. That's awesome. So I'm sorry that you guys are not able to hear me before, but you guys can hear me now. So that's cool. Another thing I'm having issues with is that I'm not going to be able to listen to the game. It's just something I'm still working on, so that kind of held me back. I had to figure out a creative solution, and I figured out I can just use Bluetooth and connect to my computer while I'm watching the live stream through the browser. So because of that, there's a bit of a lag time, and so we're gonna have some lag experience there. But yeah, I'm playing the Elder Scrolls Online, the new Necrom edition. It's pretty cool. So that's what's going on. So this is me. I look like the intro because I still have this hideous armor on. I really hope I don't go through the whole game wearing this armor. But I have some kind of trait that I tend to do that. I think I can say that. And I really don't want to do that. You know, I want to go through the whole game wearing armor outfit. But I think I did that in Oblivion. When I played Oblivion, I did something similar to that. And oh, is that somebody also in hideous armor wear? No, it's not. Yes, it is. Oh, look at you. Who are you? Oh my god, and Crystal. Hey. What level is your level? Let me see. Are you level 4? 61. No, 4. She's also new. Like me, I think. Yeah. Wait, how is she here? I don't know. Anyways. It's something I'm gonna figure out. Figuring things out. But yeah, I think when I played Oblivion was one of the first Elder Scroll games that I played, and I think I went through it wearing like the same thing. I don't remember, but I did something where I like never changed. Anyways, this game is getting pretty interesting. So, I wasn't. I think one of the biggest problems that I had with Elder Scrolls was that I did not want to sink into the story. And that was just, I guess that was a decision I made. I didn't want to sink into the story. I kind of wanted to just go through the story and just, you know, level up, defeat the monsters, get the items, and just go, 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 go. I didn't want to talk to nobody. I didn't want to hear nobody's story. nothing. And so, I think Oblivion was kind of cool. But then when Elder Scrolls Online came out, that's what happened. I was trying to take the game too fast and too, with like low interest in the story, just kind of go through. And then after a while, it was like I got lost in the story because the game sort of made it, and it was just about the story. And it was like I didn't take the time to invest in the story in the beginning, so I kind of got lost. Now that this new Necrom edition came out and I'm sitting here live streaming, I have taken the time to sort of invest into the story, sort of like a book, and it's starting to become really interesting. It's a lot. I'm still having issues with like memorizing people's names and like places, but it's getting there. There's a lot going on. I think I have 11 quests going on right now, open quests. That's the cat, and you hear the cat. Goofies. But yeah, that is pretty much what's going on. Because I'm having hardware complications, I'm gonna be Bluetooth, so that's what's going on. I'm kind of like right here right now. Fate's Proxy. This is what I'm working on. Hermaeus Mora is like, I think some Daedra or something from some realm. And there's like this other Daedra, Hermaeus Mora. No. Yeah, there's a threat against him. Yes. So I have to go to these three places here to basically go investigate them because this lady told me that I have to. I'm working as Hermaeus Mora's proxy. Hermaeus Mora came to me embodied as some like crazy octopus with an eyeball. Because Hermaeus Mora is like this, we just can't really see him because he's like this other worldly thing. And so he came to me in a tentacle looking weird thing. And Foofies, come here. Come here, Foofy. I'm his proxy now. And so I was sent to go meet. Hi, Foofy. I'm set to go meet this lady, and the, I forgot her name. But yeah, the lady is, helps her Mansmore, who I'm helping now. And she sort of like, I guess she just can see the future or whatever. She's like a fortune teller or something, but like that. One of the ones that you see in the library, like not the one with the crystal ball. She told me that I need to go to these three places so I can figure out the things I need to stop this conspiracy against Hermaeus Mora. Because Hermaeus Mora apparently already knows the future and there's something already aligned. And this conspiracy against this is going to stop this good plan of Hermaeus Mora, and it's this dark conspiracy from this bad Daedra. I believe that's what's going on. Lair Mill is the fortune teller lady I was telling you about that is helping me. So that's what's going on here. So far, I have investigated a few of these places. I need to go to another room currently. I'm working on one where there's like a cat lady that like took an amulet somewhere or something, and I have to get it back. So or a book or something like that. Anyways, I'm wrapped up in this whole story. There's a whole bunch of other stuff going on, but right now I'm right on this. I'm trying to stick with the main story. So I'm sticking to Fate's Proxy right now. I might go through all the other quests later because they're just like other things. Let's see. Senses that the bonus gun will be required to win. Okay, so connecting to Fate's Proxy, this is why it's important to stay with the story, because if you're not sticking with the story, you're going to get really confused. I'm starting to realize this. If you don't stick with the story, you're going to be running around in circles. I'm glad I figured that one out. Connecting to Fate's Proxy, I am doing Spirit of Fate, which is going to help me complete one of these tasks in Fate's Proxy. So I'm actually down here in Spirit of Fate. I'm trying to find this cat lady named Master Shelreni, I believe, who has a book or something that I need. I'm talking to somebody who's going to help me find the cat lady, Master Shelreni, because that's what I need to do to complete one of the parts of Fate's Proxy. So, these two quests are not connected, so I'd be confused, because if I came back into the game and I'm on Fate's Proxy, I'd be running around trying to figure out how do I move on in one of these quests, and it's right here. It's because I need to do this first. There's a lot of things like this in this game from what I'm reading, or I guess I read something about it. You need to finish certain quests to complete other quests. They don't exactly tell you, because you should figure it out for yourself if you're reading the story. Let's go. So we're on Spirit of Fate is where we're on right now. No, if I took a break, like if I like I don't know, if I went on vacation or if I had to do something or I'll go work somewhere for a week or whatever, I might forget that Bates proxy is connected to Spirit of Fate. But it talks about Telrendi's and Telrendi's investigate Telrendi's it's part of Fate's proxy. And Spirit of it says so Laramil the Wise, that's the fortune teller lady, basically. I guess she's just the wise. Right, so that's where we're at right now. Okay, so let's see what's on the map. This is our active quest. I think there's some things I need to do before we move on. I think my badge is full. My badge is full. My badge is full, and I don't. Don't want to go anywhere. That's a problem. I need a vendor. I don't know anything about woodworking. That's something I want to learn. I'm not doing it right now. I probably should, but I'm not. Thank you. I don't know what to do with half these things. just getting into this game. Like I said, I'm just now getting into this game. Necromagician. So, I have all these supplies. See if there's something to do with it. Alright, so it looks like I could either get more storage, which will cost me about 400 gold in the city, which I don't want to travel to a city right now, Spirit of Fate, perform a favor, so I'll take the shit out of the papers. Here we go! I'm like, I don't want to walk all over it. Papers on Mal Delby's desk. Just a servant, never mind. Anyway.
Well done. And Master Shalremi always says good help is hard to find.
It looks like that was a hunting prayer. Cool. Yes, this is me to hunt. Yeah, you gotta treat this game like a book. Cause it's a book. So I believe I'm in Telvanni. So I'm just reading about Telvanni. So this is a report that was created by a scholar. So the dark elves are accustomed to having slaves before the That's good to know, because this is why reading the story is important, because you want to know. This game gives you choices, and you want to know what choices you're making. And so, now we know something about the Dark Elves that I didn't really know. But then again, I don't know anything about this game. I know nothing about this game. Hirelings. Okay. Retainers. Thank you. cool. Okay. Okay, so those are the different levels of the Dark Elves. Dunmer, cousin, our cousins, the Dark Elves, yeah, Dark Elves. Cool. Ranks and titles of Tavani, now we know. Tavani. Tavani Peninsula. Tavani Peninsula, it's the whole thing. Necrom is the city. So yeah. Oh. I guess my guardian's excited. Okay. I mean, that was a little confusing. But it's okay. Kiki! Okay, so now we're gonna talk to Mouth Babadoo.
I see you found the papers and placed them on the correct desk. And my paws are clean in this matter. Thank you. Now it's just a matter of waiting for Mouth Delvey to resign. Then I can swoop in and claim the position.
So, what exactly was in those papers?
The less said, the better for both of us. Suffice it to say, you helped me secure a new position in accordance with the time-honored traditions of House Delvani. With my business behind us, we can see to yours.
Yes, Kiki, that's a cat. That's your cousin. So how do I gain access to Tadbaro, which is where I'm trying to find the cat lady, Master Shavani, something like that.
Take the Tadbaro insignia from my office. You'll need it to unlock the wards. Otherwise, you'll never get through the cavern to reach the tower. Master Shelreni takes security quite seriously. Now, if you'll excuse me, a mouth's work is never done. My office is through the north door and the insignia is behind my desk. Use it to unlock the wards in the cavern, or you'll never reach the tower. Tadbaro is hard to find. Look for the cavern of the tower east of Old Izra. The tower is inside.
Okay, so that's something I want to... look for the cavern of the tower east of Alt Isra. The tower is inside. Door.
We tend to the affairs of the Assembly on behalf of the masters we represent. Master Shelreni is far too important to waste her time in matters of house business. All the masters are. So we mouths make sure routine matters never trouble them. A better question is, do I think you are an assassin? Or do I even care? If you aren't, there's no danger. If you are, well, Master Shelreni can protect herself. Beyond that, I'm not sure my master and I are still on the same path.
Okay,
What's this? Looks like Mount Delvey's left some incriminating documents on their desk for anyone to see. How foolish of them.
Thank you. Okay.
Two-thirds of work is just looking busy. It's not easy, but you have to do it. Otherwise, they'll find something for you to do.
Oh. All right, I'm gonna get a drink. We're back. Thank you.
swear I saw a Morog Tongue agent come through here. Who for, I wonder?
Mushroom. So you might see me eating. It's cold in here. Oh my god, it's cold. It's freezing. Geeky, you're so lucky. Cold. All right. Amazing. Cool. So that's just snuggly. Okay, so Kiki, I know you're on the computer, so one second, girl, you're on the computer. Okay, I just need to, don't touch that button. She working. Oh. Okay. I see there's a bit of a lag in the videos and my voice. I'm still figuring out the audio hardware. So whatever, we lagging tonight, we lagging, Kiki. We ain't chilling, we lagging. All right, Lag Nation. Still don't know what these do yet, but that's okay. Must be on that new virtual computer. Alright, anyways. So I'm going to tell Borrow Car Cavern. Where is that? Borrow Cavern. tavern. Spirit of Fate, go to Telmara Cavern, show on map. They're not showing me where it is. So,
I need help. I'm trying to get to Telmara Cavern. I don't know. Can you tell me where to go? Take a left where?
Alright. So, Telmara Cavern. Well,
like I was told by Mouth. Terrible with names. I'm so sorry, but Vabduru. Okay. He told me that I need to find the entrance to Telmara Tower inside a cavern northeast of Aldithra. I should make my own way to Master Shelbrini's tower and find my way inside. Now, from all of the reading that we just did earlier, we learned a lot. We don't like Master Shelbrini. She is someone who does not, we just don't like her. So, we need to figure this out. We're not helping her anymore. I helped her earlier only because, that's a complicated thing. That was just a decision I made. Now we know we're not going to help her out with anything anymore. We're moving on from this. So I need to go northeast. Alright, so, and I just need to figure out where this place is. So, my pizza smells pretty good.
Thank you.
so I'm back. Excuse me, I am about to eat some pizza. Mellow mushroom, vegan, veg out. It is my favorite. I love it. Got a coupon from Uber Eats. Thank you, Uber Eats. No. Is that the tower? No. That's the center. Okay. No. Northeast. That must be the tower. It has to be. That must be the tower. So I have to go to the Telbaro Cavern. It looks like a cavern. Northeast. That must be up there. Or it could possibly be out there, but I doubt it. I think it's in there. The entrance, it could possibly be that. But I don't really know. I would Google it, but let me have some fun trying to find it first before I use the cheat code. I only have so much patience before I pull off the cheat code. So hold on, before I Google, let me try and find it myself. Oh my goodness, that's why I had to. That's why I had to take a break from Harry Potter, because I was Googling every 2 minutes. I failed all my classes on Harry Potter. Blunt out of Hogwarts, bitch. I forgot every spell.
Okay, well, I thought it would be a help. It's not much of a help. Alright, so I'm looking for Tilbara Cavern. I was told to go north. It's a tower, right? Yeah. So, it must be that one. Okay, so Tilbara Tower is it's out there. So Tilbara Cavern is like all the way out there. So we're gonna be walking.
Wait, hold on. Headed to Ald Izra. Oh, good, you stopped. No time for details. People eager to see me dead will come over that hill at any moment. So, want to earn some easy gold? Telhulen, the tower at Ald Izra's east end. Inside, there's a green mushroom. By that mushroom, there's a dark elf. She'll probably insult you. She's my contact. Deliver this letter, then walk away with a pocket full of gold. better you don't know. But fine. There's a spy among the Assembly of Masters. My contact's here to end the threat. Look, can you take this letter to her? Don't open it, don't look at it, don't talk about it. Hand it over and you're done. Deal? Remember, a dark elf by a green mushroom in Telhulin. Tell her, both light and shadow can be deadly. She'll reply, though only one chases the other. Then hand over the letter, and she'll give you gold. Now, go while I lead my pursuers away. The people working for the spy. That's my assumption, at least. When a dagger flew past my head, I took off. Look, you don't want to know any more about this. You don't need details to deliver a letter, and the more you know, the greater the danger. It's just another Telvanni town. Its claim to fame is that the Assembly of Masters congregates there. Look, I'm from the other side of Morrowind. I just had orders to meet my contact here and deliver that letter. Want to know more? Ask a local. We don't have time for this. Look, the name is misleading. Telvanni masters never assemble. Instead, they send their assistants, the mouths, to represent them. So it's really the Assembly of Mouths. But no one wants to call it that. Can I go now? Telhulin, I'll draw off my pursuers.
Something else I'm doing later. Oh, please don't tell me to come with me. Where are you going? Bye! Hopefully your letter don't get water damaged. Going on. Oh my goodness. This is the battle music. Something happened. Alright. Let's alright. We're all good. We're good. So we're looking for a show. Shovravani. Master Shovravani. The cat, she's a cat lady who is a master rank. And she is a bad cat. So she's like obsessed with this book. She killed this wizard and she wants this book, the magical book, and it's just like, girl, you tripping. So let's see what we can find. It's like that in here. Okay. See that dragon or whatever the hell that is up there? I have yet to see that thing come down here. Come here. Okay, so Tiviosa, Tiviosa. Alright. It's S-C-A-O. I told you, I failed Hogwarts, y'all. S-C-O-S. I don't know. Ascendio. No, that's fine. No, I don't know.
I don't know!
Alright, so. Oh my goodness. What am I doing? Not going back. Good idea. Thank you. That's weird.
Blooded around.
Okay. Well, I'm not gonna lie. Those wards seem like some, like, dark daydream stuff. Probably something she's not supposed to have. Because it's like something weird, like a pulsing heart or something, some pulsy brain. Danger. I think. Because it's not like, it's weird, and if you read the note, the others didn't know what it is. And these look so weird. I mean, they look like Daedric. Pretty sure. Maybe, maybe not. I don't know. I didn't even know this looked weird as soon as I saw it. I was like, this doesn't look right.
Thank you.
servers. They're an arrogant lot. You'll see. Meln is in my power, Tor Vassad. He'll unlock the Black Book soon enough.
You better, children. We need the right hidden within the tormenting eye, or else all is for naught.
Thank you.
This looks like a creepy place. So those words. So she's working with somebody. So we gotta take her out, or let's see.
Tell the princess, I'll uphold my end of the bargain. I expect them to uphold theirs.
A lot of books, they'd just be having around, just hanging over some candles. Just like, oh, let me put some books right over the candles. Must have been a magical time. Ooh, look, Oblivion. These are books of Oblivion. Ooh. So, Master Shabendi is not a good person. Mm-hmm.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, it's just a story that I don't even know what's going on. My brain is turning mushy. I'm getting sleepy. Broken. Then again. Oblivion. Oblivion.
Sounds like Oblivion magic around here. Unusual alliance, of course. that story.
I have no time for obstinate ghosts. You will give me access to the Black Book when I return, or else.
Over here! Quickly, before Shemreni comes back!
I see you were able to follow the clues I left in my tower. But you took your sweet time. I can't defy Shemreni much longer. If we're going to get out of here and keep me from complying with that lying murderer, you must do exactly as I say. My spirit is bound to the soul gem Shemreni used to capture me. Disentangling the connection will require more time and expertise than you have. So simply take the gem and leave. Without me, she may never be able to unlock my Black Book. Shemreni took the Black Book with her, but without my help, she'll have to unriddle it page by page. The labor of days or weeks, not hours. If she can even accomplish it, she's too fond of the easy path to power. It will be her undoing someday. She doesn't need it at all. She's in league with a Dremora, Torvasard, and a pair of Daedric princes. There's apparently a rite contained within the book they want her to cast. In return, they'll give her what she wants. Control of House Telvanni. Gem in your possession. I can come and go as I please. Now use that portal and let's go.
All right, you guys. I think I'm out. With the Bluetooth. Thanks for joining me. I hope you guys have a great Saturday night. I'll catch you on one of my other shows or on this one. Hopefully I'll figure out better ways to get some better stream interaction, content, borders, headlines, whatever. Anyways, peace out.
Bye.